Hey guys, my name's John Banks, and today we are with...
me, Jack Hobson, Jack's Up Worlds.
And, yep, Jack Up Worlds, check him out. And today we are doing our new podcast. We're carrying on with the same name,
Film Talks,
but... basically, it's just going to be about me and Jack Up Worlds, or Jack Hobson, talking about our channels, what's been doing on in our film lives, what we're creating... what's coming out on our channels. So, Jack, why do you start us off with your first topic?
Well, first topic is pretty much what I started doing at uni. And the first thing I kind of started doing was learning how to make a set and how to dress a location into whatever you're going for. So we were going for... kind of a courtroom kind of setting, so we had to do research onto what is in your courtroom, like just for normal stuff, like we had to look at what kind of files there are because there's different colours depending on the case, and then we had to look at what kind of ribbon is tied around the file because there's different colours for that, and it's pretty stupid, but went into that, and then we had to make
some stuff that you got to get exact in it.
Yeah, and then we had to get models. We had to make models of the set, pretty much, to measure the doors and the floor and how much space we'd have to work with, and then we could give that model to the director and the cinematographer so that they could plan out their shots ahead of the schedule. Which was really good.
Nice. Yeah.
What about you?
Yeah. Well, literally, in about an hour and 10 minutes after I finished filming this, I'm going outside to finish up my filming. I've got like 2 or 3 scenes to shoot. And it's basically a kind of like a drug kind of film. Like a short film, but we're not using actual drugs because a bit dangerous.
Obviously.
There's some guy there in the middle of the street like taking cocaine.
was it Trainspotting that used real drugs?
I think it's Trainspotting, you know.
It might have been. Was it not something? I think like Fear and Self-Loathing in Las Vegas. Or
maybe
something.
I think
that.
It was Trainspotting though.
I feel like it was Trainspotting.
Yeah. So ours is called. It's about Palmer Violets. You know what they are, Jack? You know, have you heard of them?
The little sweets.
Kind of like little purple sweets.
I love them.
Yeah. And it's basically about a guy who's addicted to these, and
it's me.
It's my friend as well, according to me. That's why we made this. But yeah, I'll put in a short snippet here for you guys, tiny bit for a teaser kind of thing. Mate, what the fuck's going on, Lucas? Lucas, what's this? What the fuck? What the fuck? Who are you? Who even are you?
Very nice.
Yep, and basically he's addicted, and he brings up kind of like an interviewer kind of person in to help him, and they follow his like day-to-day life of him like trying to get over the addiction and find out all the stuff that's going on happening, and his housemates as well. So I won't spoil it too much, but we should finish filming today and it should be up like next week or in 2 weeks time,
and I'm sure you'll let everyone know on your channel.
Yep, I'll make a video of something going on. I'll make like a short video, like 2 minutes, saying the film where we're up to and when it would be out and that, and keep an eye out. It should be really good. And this is the first one I've directed.
Oh, you're directing?
I'm directing. I'm starring in it as well, but there's other people starring it, but I've directed it.
Oh, you're pulling a Sandler, an Adam Sandler.
There's a lot of people who've done that, though. I've directed it, and I've come up with the ideas, but my friends, they helped a lot. They've come up with some ideas themselves. So, yeah, it should be really, really good.
Okay.
So, what else have you been up to, Jack? What has been going on in your film life?
I also did this. These were in the same 2 weeks, the first 2 weeks of uni.
Okay.
I did the production design, which was the set and all that.
Yeah.
And then I also did the sound recordist, which is kind of like sound design. But pretty much when you are on location and you're filming, you are in charge of all the sound on the film.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I did that other week. I'll tell you that in a minute.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, you'll know what I'm on about, but
yeah.
For everyone listening, it's like when they say, like, lights, camera, action, like, they don't actually say that. They say turnover, and then the camera says speed. I don't know why. Or running in America.
Speed, he's just doing some cheeky speed, and I'm leaving.
Yeah, I know, it's just, we're doing... Speed.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's how it came about.
Speed.
That's probably from Trainspotting.
I need speed.
I am speed. anyway, and then they go sound, and then sound goes check, and then they go clear. I don't know why. I don't know why it turned into lights, camera, action. Maybe that's from the golden age of Hollywood.
I think it's from classical Hollywood era.
Yeah.
It sounds like more professional anyway.
It does, doesn't it? But yeah, now we say turnover sound clear, which isn't as catchy.
No, but
and it's not nearly as fun.
No,
in fact, we don't even say that's a rap anymore.
Ah.
Now we just kind of say, "Fuck off." That's it, really.
Fuck off in a minute, mate. who's coming to the pub?
Bye. Yeah, that's it. Pub.
It just every time somebody just says pub on you, it just reminds me of Shaun of the Dead or Hot Fuzz. What do you do now? Pub.
Pub. Right. But yeah, so I did sound recordist on that, and my actual credit would be for sound recordist, I think, for that film. But yeah, it went well. We had a slight issue of echo because we're in the town hall.
Okay.
But we ended up doing it all right because we just kind of talked very quietly, and then we got the boom really close.
Yeah.
And that minimised the echo. And then we recorded some Foley after, which, if you don't know, is like sound effects you add in afterwards. But it's sound effects you captured on location. It's like footsteps, doors, things like that.
Just like casual stuff.
And then we recorded some, Atmos.
Nice.
And used that. And that was the first 2 weeks.
Jesus, sounds like
our first
a very
cycle.
Busy 2 weeks.
We do. We have very busy cycles. Every cycle lasts 2 weeks, and that was our first 2 weeks.
See, so if you're wondering why Jack doesn't upload, and neither have
I, we've
got a lot of stuff going on, alright?
That's why neither of us upload. If you dare underestimate the work film,
are you joking? Whatever, mate. I've been here before. I've been here for 2 years. You don't think I know this?
I mean people.
Oh, right. I thought you were talking to me. Like, you doubt
it.
I was like,
I'm studying film at uni, and they're just like, what? It's like,
you
do more work than
study,
you.
You study film. What do you mean? You sit there and watch a film? No, mate. We don't sit there and watch a film. Sit there and use your brain power for fucking 4 hours until she asks you the most complex fucking psychological questions known to man.
For the past 2 cycles, I've not sat down. Like,
well, you do film with film production, don't you?
I do film production, yeah. So I do less... theory. I do more practical.
I do no theory, but I have to create my own theory because it's better for me.
Yeah, so
but
it's
I do
like,
all theory, but you would doubt what theory is like. It's not easy. We had a class in it.
Oh no! I did theory at college.
Yeah,
you know
it's hard.
You know, yeah.
We was in realism. She asked the most like hardest questions known to man. She's like, "How can a film like there's a thing on Total Cinema? And if you don't know what Total Cinema is, it's like how close can you come to watching a perfect film?" Emotion. Talking about pain now.
In perfect pain.
Yeah, perfect pain. But basically, how like immersed can you be in a film? And I was like, you can be immersed as you want, but it's never going to be total cinema. And Andrew Bazin, a theorist, a French New Wave theorist, argues that you cannot. And I was like, we've got VR and shit like that, but we're never going to become perfectly stuff. And she's
fully
like,
immersed.
But what about this? And he's like, what? What? Just proper just messes with your mind. It's like psychological fucking...
The French New Wave banter is
French New Wave. Well, I really like the French New Wave. It's good. topic to talk about.
I think it's very interesting to talk
Dogma
about.
If you're not
interested in film, it could be very
boring. if you're just like, if you go to a guy and go, Fresh New Way, they're like, what? But
you're like, you don't understand the impact it had on film.
You don't understand where the French New Wave came from. You don't even know what...
You weren't there, man.
Neither was we.
That's a good point.
But, yeah, Dogma 95 as well.
Yeah, Dogma 95 is another one. Those banter. Yeah,
if you just go on YouTube and search in Dogma 95 to create a film, there's a short, like, 5-6 minute clip about Dogma 95 and how it influenced creating a film. And we... It's Sweet. Pretty good. It shows you like all the rules and how they implied into the film. Some of that, you know, like Fisher, some of that we should have been shown. Because it basically shows an action film. Like a clip from an action film, and then it puts in rule by rule what happens and like gets rid of sets and props and guns and sound effects. So,
it
helps you a lot to understand the rules. So if you check that out, if you're interested, if you're not, then just don't.
Yeah, it's good stuff to know if you are interested.
Yeah, if you want to study film as well.
Yeah, because, well, if you don't intend on studying film and you just want to make short films on your own and get into the industry that way, that's fine. That's what a lot of people in the industry do. But it's useful to study it in your own time and know, because when you get on set,
just talk about film.
People will just talk like that. Like they'll just. It'll be all in film language, and they won't expect you to not know it, pretty much.
Film talks,
you
Jack, I've got raging film
films. And if you don't, they'll just fire you.
And making short films. Them. Make sure you do, because as soon as you leave uni, and you want to start applying for jobs in Media City, BBC, ITV, whatever,
it's
London, they expect you to have a film reel of what you've done. A show reel, sorry. Show reel, and if you got all your stuff on YouTube, you can cut down to the bits you like, and you need the full clips. You can check everything out on YouTube. This is everything I've done. So if you're going to compare then against somebody who's done one film and you've done four or five films, three or four podcasts, you'll be like, well, I've still got experience. I've done. It shows your teamwork skills as well. It shows a lot of stuff.
Yeah, pretty much.
But go on.
Yeah, it's passion, teamwork. Maybe creativity in some aspects, and just like the will to get up and do things on your own merit. Yeah, you can't wait to be asked to do something.
Yeah, you can't just leave it to your tutors or whoever.
It's way beyond A levels.
It's not like high school, or I would say like a bit like A levels with like. Okay, now we're going to get a camera.
Yeah.
It's like, now we're going to get a camera and we're going to point it at him and zoom in. And this is
like,
called
right,
a zoom in.
Get the cameras on. We got the cameras from the technicians. And then we sat down and he went, right, set up your cameras, do your square ones, do your white balance, get the zebras up. And then I want a tunnel view on this subject over here. And he was like, right, go. And I was just sat there like, I'm like, yeah. So eventually, there's a few of us like that. So eventually, I put my hand up and I'm like, Chris, what
day is it?
And he went, oh, do you not know how to do it? And I'm like, not really. And he went, right, finally, someone is being honest. And he said, that's what I wanted to hear. He's like, someone that wants to learn. So he came over to me, taught me how to do it. And then he was like, does anyone else not know? And no one said anything. And I'm like, what the hell? None of you know what you're doing. And then he went, right, when I'm back, everyone should have their cameras set up and ready. Go. And he left. And then as soon as he left, everyone turned to me and went, everyone, Jack, what do you do? And I'm like, why did you not ask? I was like, you saw how nice he was. Just ask him.
Everybody's like, Jack.
But yeah, if you were on set and the director said, get the camera set up and did all this, and you said, what? Fired. You're out. You're gone.
You'll be out. You're out. Maybe one or two chances if it's really hard shot, you're like, what? And he's like, but if it's more simple, like, all right, I want to zoom in on this guy's face and I want a quick zoom out, turn onto this subject straight away. If you're like, oh, well, I can't do that, but like, you're out.
Yeah, like,
get somebody else
like
in.
You're not doing that.
The industry's that tough.
Yeah, instead of, like, in some industries, it'd be, okay, well, this is what you have to do. But in this industry, it's, okay, bye. Get someone that knows what they're doing.
I want this. summit. So in other industries, like, this is what I want you to do, yeah, doing your own A. This one is the director going, I want you to do this, you do this, yeah, how I want it done. Was no,
unless,
there's no,
unless you're
maybes.
Cinematographer. If you're a cinematographer, then you're allowed to,
yeah,
not argue with the director, but say, don't you think this would look better? And then put your viewpoint in front, and he'd be like, oh, maybe, yeah, good idea. Because cinematographer, yeah, their official role is to be in charge of everything in the frame. So, pretty much, when you see a film,
yeah,
like, we'll go with Jurassic Park because it's a famous film by a famous director. You think when you see Jurassic Park, you think, "Oh, that's Steven Spielberg's film," and well, it is, and it's his vision. But
yep,
yeah, the
that Steven Spielberg would say what he wants.
Probably the cinematographer designed them frames, and probably him that came up with the shots. Yeah. Steven Spielberg would have said to the cinematographer, okay, I imagine this happening, yeah, and I imagine this happening, and I imagine this, yep, happening, after he read the script. Kind of like when you read a book, you imagine it in your head. That's what a director does with a script. And then he tells the cinematographer what he imagines, and the cinematographer is like, okay, goes out, draws a storyboard, draws out the shots, says it did the kind of thing, and the director usually says no, and then you have to go out and do it again. And then he says this, and the director goes no, and you have to do it about 4 or 5 times, and the director will be like, yeah, that's it. And you're like, yeah, and then you go on set, and then it all changes again. And it just keeps changing, so.
Squad up. Yeah. But you got to think of it as well, it's not all the film, it's not just a director's point of view. You've got directors, you've got co-directors, you've got producers, you've got screenwriters. A film is not just all one person.
Yeah, sometimes even
whole,
sound will
come
whole come
team
forward
put
and be
together
like,
to
yeah,
make
we
a
can't
film.
Do this shot. I'll be like, why? Because the sound. Cause they'll be like, yeah, well, it wouldn't sound, yeah, like that. So.
Well, it's like sound. Like screenwriters need
some
to
directors
write the
will be
screenplay.
Like, okay, we'll go for the most realistic, yeah, one. And some directors will say, I don't care, record the sound somewhere else and put it in. Yeah. Change the laws of physics, Dad.
No, okay. I want it my way.
That's it.
Bloody.
That's Stanley Kubrick. Yeah. Stanley Kubrick.
We need to,
like,
make rain go up. How do we do this? I don't know. Figure it out. Yeah. Yeah. Change it now. We can't change physics.
In our last year,
I am God. I do what I want.
We had a scene where rubble falls down from the ceiling. So we shot this scene, and then we dropped like some sand with a few stones in it, and we just dropped it down in front of the camera, and it hit the floor, and our director went, cut, and we were like, what? And he went, it just sounds wrong. We're like, what? He's like, it just doesn't sound right. And we're like, yeah, but that's the sound of the location. He's like, that's as realistic as we're going to get it. And he goes, no, I didn't want that sound. And then we stood there for about an hour while he was going, I wanted that sound where it goes like off rocks. And we're just like, what? What are you on about? Just like,
we're not fucking.
He was
we're not in a major
sound
production
like
here,
hour,
making
like,
a footage feature-length film.
Like this. And then the sound guy was like, "Oh my god, I don't know what to do with my life."
Going back onto topic after we had a little detour, but it's talking about film. I've not made a film. I helped with the sound like you were on about. I did boom mic and stuff like that. I didn't come up with any ideas. My friend just needed my help to do the actual sound. So that should be up actually on our Raging Film channels. Cheeky plug. Yeah, it should be up on Raging Film films. But I did the sound for it. And the problem that we had is that we was in a local area because it's two people sat on a couch trying to decide what film to watch. One's pretentious as fuck. Like, yeah, we should watch, like, you know, Battleship Potemkin. It's got like a £2 million budget. I'm like, nah, let's just watch fucking Hunger Games.
Yeah.
So it's basically like that. And the problem that we had when filming it is that the light we used is in the middle of the room and it's quite bright, but it casted a shadow straight over. So whenever I tried to put the boom mic in, it wasn't low enough to the people to hear. And when I tried to get it lower, the shadow got in the way.
The shadow was there.
The shadow got in the way. So you had to, like, they had to sit on the floor in the middle of the tripod. Like, in the middle of the tripod.
Did you do the old boom mic underneath trick?
Yeah, and then keep turning it to other people's conversations. But it's a really good film. You should check it out when it comes out.
That's another thing about lighting people might not realize. There's 4 points of lighting in film. There's key lighting, fill lighting, back lighting, and another kind of lighting that I didn't pay attention to.
No, it's three. It's three key stage of lighting. I think there's only three.
Oh, there's four. There's four.
Is it? No, because there's one. Yeah, there's one. Four. Oh, yeah, there is.
There's three main ones.
Three main ones.
Which
and
is key,
yeah.
Fill, back. And then there is a fourth, yeah. But I don't know what the fourth is. Maybe he just didn't tell us. Maybe he said there was four,
yeah,
but you only need to know three.
That's the three main
maybe
ones.
That's what he said. Key is like, if you're outside, pretty much, key is sun. And it's like just the main fill of the scene. Then there's that, which sounds weird because I'm about to say fill. It's just everything else in the scene. And then back is from behind, pretty much. But you have to light it in such a way that nothing is too bright. I heard that. Jordan's got his Morrison's
brand. Fuck up, just because I live in Unit doesn't mean I drink fucking Roller Cola Morrison's brand.
I live in Unit.
I sat here drinking Pepsi, right?
Yeah, well, we're film students, we have less money.
Why? All my money goes on equipment.
It does. All of our money goes on set.
Well, talk about equipment, you just bought a new mic, didn't you?
I did, I'm using it now, so I hope it... Oh, I don't know what it's picking up to me. It could be picking up anything. It could be picking up me doing this.
I heard like a tiny bit of
I don't know if you can hear
much.
Anything. I don't know if it's picking up me.
We're not gonna go through mic tests.
Or drinking.
Just that you've got a new mic.
No. Yeah, it's just it's really good. It was like it was quite expensive actually. It was about £20. It's got a 2 meter cable for some reason, but it's USB, just plugged into your computer, and it's a little clip on mic. So yeah, I didn't want like a
that me
big fat one to put on my desk. Yeah, like you. But I'm also going to get a smaller one that plugs into my phone, and then use that whenever I'm walking to locations.
Here's
stuff.
Another thing we were thinking
about.
Just
do little vlogs.
What would you guys think about like vlogs on a film shoot?
Yeah, that's something we could think about doing. I don't think we'd be... Well, I know I wouldn't be able to do proper vlogs on set.
Yeah, I can do a vlog outside
of
my set because
I'm about to shoot
my own production. Or if it's somebody else, they wouldn't mind.
Yeah, sure, stuff. Mine, most stuff I'm going to do is going to go through uni or actual production companies if Chris pulls through and actually gets me jobs like he said he's gonna. Chris is a babe, by the way. He's our cinematographer tutor, and I got mixed up with sound designer because I like sound.
But
Oh, that's another thing. All of my tutors are currently still working in the industry. That's like a a requirement for working at our uni. That they have to still be in the industry. Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I think our tutors was in the industry.
All of our tutors have like...
They all write books on it. Like, they've all got published books.
Yeah.
So it's not like we don't... It's not like they don't know anything. It's not like they just pulled them off, a random person off the street and go, film studies, do you know? Like, I know what a camera is. Okay, you're required.
I think it's the best thing in the world to talk about.
But,
because there's many different things.
It's a really good subject. It's a really interesting thing to talk about.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, we could,
we could talk about this for hours, but we're not going to do because it'd be a bit boring after a while for you guys.
Yeah.
Not for me and Jack. Me and Jack sit here for hours and hours talking about fucking French New Wave. To be fair, we did this in A-level. We just got bored and started to talk about Fight Club. Yeah, Fight Club.
Oh, it's because of our teacher. But yeah, another day.
We had some weird stuff in A-levels.
No one knows who our teacher.
We'll come back to that until another day.
Anyway.
Don't be saying that. You can't say that. But anyway,
Before
we started, you told me you had a story to tell me, and I've not heard this story. You just went and wanted to hear my reaction. So,
because I'm kind of going through this chronologically, just because I've got my essay up now. So, And you know how I said I do cycles of like 2 weeks?
Yeah, a list.
Well, our second cycle, we had animation and production management. And not to be confused with production design. Production design was the sets. Production management is like producing, things like that. And that didn't really interest me because that's very business side of things. And it's very boring. And I don't want to do that. Yeah, pretty much... It's their film, pretty much.
The producers, they sort out all that. Like, cast when time to come in.
Yeah, they even hire the directors.
Like, what time to come in?
Which is insane.
Make sure you hear
about
this
think
time.
About it. Because you always think of a time. Film it's being a director's side. Film. But it's actually the producer's film, and they never get any credit, which is weird.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, it depends.
Even though we went on a tangent about directors being the film, right? Just keep that in mind, but think about producers as well.
It's just preference.
Yeah. Don't even get me started on the auteur theory, right? I've studied this.
I don't
I've been
go
studying
on
the
it.
Auteur theory now for like 3 weeks straight. If you want to go on to the auteur theory, Jack, I'll just bring in French New Wave, Andrew Bazin. Well then. That's
just
all
get up
we've
and
been
leave
doing
the
last
spot.
3 weeks and now all my lessons, like, if we bring it back to the auteur theory, I was like, don't want to talk about it anymore.
I think that producers need more.
Like,
more
jump out of a window.
But anyway, I chose to do animation because I thought it would be completely different to anything that I'm going to do. Because I don't want to go into animation, but I thought, lad, I'd like to know what it's like. Yeah, so I did it. And it was all stop motion because
you're always good.
I don't think they're expecting us to be able to draw, but I know if you carry it on, there is some drawing or something like that. And there's like, and there's like model making on computer and stuff like that.
Yeah, I'm
but
shit
no, drawing. We made the models by hand and then did stop motion. And oh my god, it was hard. It was so hard. We had to do 90 seconds. Of 24 frames a second, and it took all day. It was from 9 till 5. It took all day. And that was with two sets, by the way. We had two sets set up. So it took ages to do. But it came out alright, and I think we got pretty good marks for it. But we don't actually find out till the end of the year, which is annoying. But yeah, it was an experience.
I guess it was.
It was really good. If you ever get a chance, I suggest that you give it a go.
Talking about animation, did you see the TV trailer for Cars?
Scary.
Well, you see it on Facebook. Did you see? It looks dark.
I know.
I think they're going for. It's just so happy. If you've not seen
so
it it's on YouTube, it's trending like number one. It's got like 5 million views in 2 days because it's teaser. It's basically
it's
all
like,
it is
you know
it's Lightning McQueen
the first
around
race.
Around
no, not the first race. The second race
flipping through the air,
of
like,
cars.
Pieces.
Where is it? The king, the blue car. Yeah, the big race, and then he crashes. Yeah, it's kind of like that crash.
Yeah, oh, the last race in the case.
So
last race, yeah. Yeah, it's like that.
Yeah,
and it just like,
that,
it,
yeah.
There's a title at the end that gets you just like, this is a life-changing moment, or something like that.
What?
And you're like, shit, fuck. But I don't think they might be going for. Do you know in the first one, remember Hudson Hornet? I think they're going for that kind of feel with it again, because that's how he lost it. He crashed, and he's like, every car has his moment when he crashes.
That'd be cool.
So I think he's rather going to carry on and he's crashed and he's going to go back to Radiator Springs. Or
and then definitely.
I think they might be going for that feel, but I don't know. We have to wait till the trailer comes out, but I'm interested. It's got me excited for it.
We're film students. We have to watch every film.
Not if you judge us because
we
watch Disney films. They've got they've got hidden meanings in them. You know, study.
Yeah.
But if we carry on. Yeah, what am I doing? I am starting to upload back onto YouTube again. After this. 3 week, because I've had a lot of exams going on and stuff. Don't forget, I do 3 modules as well, so I've got to do 3 exams or 3 coursework, and they've got to be in like, once the deadline's for one, it's like in a week or 2 week gap with 3 things, like an essay, and a test. So we finally finished them, so I started to upload on YouTube again. So I'll be posting more Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered, and I might post some Infinite Warfare, but it's pretty, I don't really like the game.
After everything Warfare, I said so. About it.
Yeah, and you was thinking about getting Jack, weren't you?
Yeah. I'm not paying that much for it.
And then I posted my gameplay. It looks pretty good, you know. Yeah, you're gonna have to.
It does look pretty good.
You can never resist COD.
Well, I might have to get it.
It's like me with FIFA. I did that last year with FIFA.
No, I actually can't. FIFA. Every year I'm like, not getting this one, and then I end up getting it.
17.
Yeah, you did. This year, I was like, you're getting FIFA 16.
No, I'm not going to get this year.
And he's like,
comes out Friday. Came out Thursday. I was like, starting getting like really good. Craving for it. I was like, FIFA, so must get FIFA. I was set in my seminar.
I have to get it. It'd be like
I was
me.
Sat in my seminar.
Saying, I'm
like,
not
I played FIFA a bit, but I've not played it much.
17.
Like in 3 weeks, 4
like,
weeks.
That would not
I was sat in my seminar when it came out on Argos, trying to see if they got any copies for a reserve. Like a reserve and a copy of my seminar. I was like, neither did I.
Yeah, I went to game because I didn't pre-order it. I went to game. I was like,
yeah.
Got any FIFA
17
left?
I went to Morrison's
like, oh,
and they had
last
Xbox
one
copies. PlayStation 3 copies and like Xbox 360 copies. So I was like, there's no PS4. What the fuck is going on?
It was the same with Skyrim. I was like,
I've never played Skyrim.
Skyrim,
never interested, but I'm not really
like,
into
yeah,
that kind
got
of game.
Like 4 left. I'm like, yes.
I must say, it's not a good game for people to play. It looks amazing, like dragons, fighting
it's
dragons.
So,
and stuff.
I love it. I love it.
I do like fighting dragons and stuff. It's just I don't like walking around like massive,
yeah, if
massive
you're into this kind
open
of thing,
world and collecting
really
things.
Good.
It just, yeah, but it just doesn't really interest me. Like going to a load of different places.
You can fast travel.
I don't know. It's just a game that doesn't really interest me. I'm like, okay. I'm more like carry on. Yeah, that's my fault. Sorry.
Anyway, transitioned into games from film. Yeah, that was your film. So that was my second trying.
All right. Well, while you're looking at this, I'll talk about what other films that ideas I'm doing.
I'm just looking
I'm
at this list and I've done
other film ideas after we've filmed this one.
Yeah,
hopefully get
filmed
today and then we can start editing. But my next idea and the one I want to produce and work on and do cinematography and that for is called, are you ready, Jack? Not All Fun and Games, alright? So just keep that title in mind for my pitch of the idea. And basically the pitch of it is about, follow this house mate, so like partying and like, yeah, taking drugs, like let's stay up to like, oh, do all nighters, taking all the Parma Violets, you know, like let's stay up all night and just party and stuff, drink all the day and do shots. Do you know, typical uni students. Yeah, we are going to. Yeah. See, the Parma Violet trilogy.
Tell you what you should do. What you should do.
You just heard it
for,
here.
For the drugs, you should use Parma Violet.
Yeah, we're
going to. And that could be like your little tie into your other films.
Sorry, just having a drink.
There you
just
go.
Like, typical. Yeah, I just felt like I needed a drink, you know. So I did this in. No, but show up. But it's
halfway
follow,
through a sentence.
Like a typical.
Oh, so
it's
I did
do
this
all
thing,
the typical
right?
What
and then
people
we started off on
do is stay up all night, taking shots of vodka for no reason. You know, they're gonna exam the day after, but like, fuck it, we're gonna drink. Shut the fuck up, right? I don't drink Smirnoff Ice, right? I've changed.
Drinking WKD.
Yeah, I did Copperberg.
Smirnoff Ice.
Copperberg.
Jordan drinks Smirnoff. You've changed.
Yeah, but, it's
I've changed.
All the typical
I'm a
things
changed
people
man.
Do, think people think uni students do, and then it's going to
drink
cut.
What?
to following this uni student who's got exams. He's stressing about exams. He's worrying
it's
about
nice
his
in
life.
The summer.
He's like can't get to sleep because he's worrying about results and stuff like that. And he's basically just going to follow on that premise. So what do you think? That's our next project. So what else have you been doing, Jack?
I think it sounds pretty good. Yeah? Hang on, just.
Do you want me filling some music?
I'm still editing. it's once I've seen a mistake, I have to kind of fix it, or else I'll never get back.
Oh, is this a story? Okay, I'm listening.
Second. Okay, Command S. No, I've done it now. Okay, so this is the story. This is where the story comes in. Yeah, this was our third cycle, second to last one. We're about to go into our fourth. And we're doing cinematography in this. And cinematography is such a big subject. It's the only one you study in this cycle. Because there's just so much stuff to do. And I signed up for cinematographer, which is kind of the main thing we teach at uni. So there's a lot of pressure on to get this right.
You just have to pursue.
And I signed up really late for it. and I didn't know what I had to do. Because no one tells you what a cinematographer does until you have to know what it is and you go and ask someone. I signed up for it and then I asked Chris, who is a cinematographer in the industry. I was like, I've signed up for this. I was like asking him quietly on the down low. I was like, because I didn't want people to think I'm stupid. So I'm like, Chris, he was like, yeah, what's up? And I was like, shh, shh. They can't know we're talking, and he was like, okay, because he's proper chilled, he's really funny. So he was like, okay. So he just like turned back to his computer, and I was like, don't make it obvious we're talking. And he was like, yeah, okay. He's like, okay, what are you doing? And I was like, so I've signed up to cinematography, and he's like, yeah, what? And I'm like, I just went, what does a cinematographer do? And then he turned around and he just went, what? And I'm like, what does a cinematographer do? And he went, oh, for God's sake. And then he actually went, right, everybody. He went, Jack's just asked me what a cinematographer does after all this. And I'm like, Chris, I trusted you. What are you doing? And then like the class was just like silent. And he was like, who wants to fill him in? And no one put the hand up. They do it. Does anyone know what a cinematographer does? Shit. And then like one dude put his hand. And then we're like, and then he was like, okay. And then that's when he
just
told us.
Just presume what they do. Yeah, you. This is what you.
And, all that shit. And I was like, oh, okay, thanks, Chris. And then
right,
he was like,
we
should probably start teaching people that.
Next it's from.
Like, it's a good idea.
I'm not calling it bad. Yeah. I'm not calling it bad. It was
like
a good
that's how good our uni is. They think that
college.
We all know shit already.
To be fair, you did get in and out. Sorry, carry on.
I went to Bournemouth Sixth Form. Yeah, I did go to Hollywood Sixth Form.
All right,
it was
all right. Story then.
It's fine. Yeah. But that wasn't the story.
Oh, the prelude to the story. Okay.
I'm just saying, like, I didn't want to get your hopes up and then give you that and think that and make you think that was the story. That wasn't the story.
Okay.
That was not the story. That was the prelude to the story. Yeah.
Okay.
So I got into this crew because we have to sign up to our own crews, and because that's what you do in the industry. So they want to make it as real as they can. And if you don't sign up, you just get a zero. So yeah, you have to sign up for something. So I signed up cinematographer, and I was like, I'm just gonna go balls in. And just do it. So I signed him, and then went through all that with Chris, and then I went to a meeting that we'd set up. Oh, right, that's where it all started. The production manager sets up the meetings, and he set up this meeting. Didn't give us a room, just said we're going to meet at the library, and we were like, okay. So we got to the library at the right time, and then we were all waiting for ages. We're like, where's Remy? He was our production manager. Like, where's Remy? And he's like, oh, I don't know, let's message him. So we messaged him. He's like, oh, I'm not coming. Like, what? He's like, yeah, you'd need me there. Like, you set up the meeting. It's like, oh, yeah, well, ah, I didn't think we'd have to be there. And he's like, what room are we in? And then, because he didn't tell us the room. So he's like, oh, we're in this room. So we went and went to the room.
Okay.
And then there was a code on the door. And we're like, how do we get in? So we went down to the front desk and asked. And they were like, okay, so which one is Remy? He's the one who booked the room. So they could only give the code to him. So we had to explain what happened. And eventually they let us into the room. And then we got in and we went through it all. And I was like, so I don't know what I'm doing because I've not been taught how to do cinematography yet. That's next week. So my director had already come up with all of the shots that he wanted to do. So I'm like, that's fine with me. He was like, I'm cool with you taking credit on all of this. I'm like, all right, okay. So we went through just for a while and then it eventually got to our test day. And I'd come up with some more shots to put into the film since then. So I have contributed. We were filming on location in the Victorian cells in the Leeds Town Hall. And they literally are Victorian cells. They're just cells that were built in the Victorian times for holding prisoners before they were put in front of a judge. And it's really cold down there, and there's like no lights. And because our film was set during World War II, so it was like a little bunker that it was set in. And we went down there, and it's underneath. It's like got a curved wall on one side, and it's underneath the steps leading up to the town hall. And I didn't know that at the time, but it was described to us later on, and I'll get to that. We were there and we were setting up our shots, and our director had some really good ideas. And we were like, okay, so we'll do this establishing shot from that end of the corridor, and it'll look really good because we'll have a really like dingy lighting set up, and it'll look really good like World War II. And we were so excited, we were buzzing because we were like, oh, we've sorted it, yeah, buzzing. And then we had like another scene in one of the cells that was going to be like a torture scene. And we were going to do a lot of camera trickery because you're not allowed to actually torture anyone. So it's going to be really good. And we were like, oh, we're going to get so many marks. Yeah. And we were so excited. We were like, oh. And then we're going to split the camera into three. And we're going to have the rule of thirds. And it's going to have and we're going to focus on the one in the middle. And it's going to have foreground. And it's going to be beautiful. And Chris is going to just like orgasm. He's going to give us like all of the marks. He's going to be like, yes. And then we went for lunch. Yes. We came back, and this hurricane that Florida's had, or like that, yeah. Well, it's come across to us, hasn't it? And like we've had all the rain, and like all this like shit. Well, it hit like at lunchtime, like for real. So what we did. We went to a bit of rain and fucking electrocute you. Teaching place to get all of our equipment for our test shoot.
We
got all the equipment and we carried it all in the rain. All these plugs and everything, like them 3-pinned, 16-volt massive plugs. And we're just like, yeah, when you get a bit of rain in and you lose it, it's gone. And then we got all the lights and you probably know the lights. For some reason, are not waterproof. They are like massive ass lights that you could put outside to light up a nice outside scene, but they're not waterproof. And we didn't get given any waterproof casing for them for some reason. Don't know why. In the middle of this torrential storm, and we carried it. It's about 10 minutes away. We had to carry it all. The full set load of equipment, carry it all between us down to the town hall in the rain, and we did that. And we got there, And our first AD, our assistant director, walked in first, signed us all in, and then went into the set, and we were all behind
fine,
him, and he just went, "Whoa, stop, stop, stop." So we all stopped, and he went, "Everyone put everything down." He went, "Just put everything down right now." We could tell he was stressing out about something, and we had no idea. Sorry if you can hear that, by the way, outside. He was like stressing about something.
Yeah.
He went, "Right, everyone put everything down." He went, "Oh my god, oh my god," and we were like, "What's going on?" And he went, "Oh god," he went, "Jake," which is our director. He went, "Jake, Tabitha," who is our second director. He went, "Gaffer and cinematographer," because he didn't know my name. he's like, "Everyone, come here right now, all of you." So we're like, "Oh god, what did we do? Oh god." So we went across, because Toby, our first AD, second year who didn't pass, and then had the chance to redo one set of lessons, but would take him a year, or do all of the lessons again. If he did all the lessons again, he would get to make more films to add to his showreel. So it was a no-brainer, because it wouldn't cost him any extra. So he thought, I might as well. So that's why he was with us. But he knew exactly what he was doing, so he just pretty much followed his lead all day. He was like, "Right, everyone come here right now." So we moved to the front of the line, and everyone's just kind of loitering around like, "What's going on?" And we went in. And I was about to turn the light on, and he went, "Don't you touch that light." He said, "You touch that light, we all die." I'm like, "Whoa, like, what is going on?" He went, "Everyone get your torches on, because you're going to give them torches." So we put our torches on. And like I say, it's been raining all day, and the entire of the Victorian cells has just flooded up to, like, ankle height. And we are like, "What?" And this is Victorian cells, okay? The lighting.
Jack's like, "Yeah, you know what? We're just going to
check
the electricity on free water."
Like, the wiring and everything. That's why he didn't want me to turn the lights on. He was like, "The switches and everything, it's all underwater." It's like, "We turn that on, it's all electrified."
No.
I'm like, "Okay, I'm not touching that switch." I'm like, So he's like, "Right." He was like, "I'm pretty sure we can't film down there." So, because, like I say, all of these lights and stuff, all the equipment, none of it's waterproof.
Yeah.
So we were like, "What do we do?" And he was like, "Right." He was like, "Cinematographer." He learned my name by the end of the day, but he was like, "Cinematographer." He's like,
"Right."
He's like, "Get Chris on the phone," because we get given their phone numbers on a call sheet. He was like, get Chris on the phone."
Yeah.
And he was like, "Director, get Karen on the phone," who is like the set person. She's in charge of, she's the production design teacher, so she's in charge of location as well. So I get her on the phone, and he's like, "I'll ring Chris Clarkson," who is our health and safety. He's like, "I'll ring them," and he said, "Tabitha, can you get Chris Brook," who is our head of year, he said, "can you get them all on the phone?" He said, "And then we need to meet them back here," but we had to go upstairs to ring them because we were underground, so we didn't have any coverage. So we went, and we rang them, and then they said they'd be on the way. So we went downstairs, and this is our test shoot. We have one test shoot, and then we shoot the day after. So this was our test shoot, and keep in mind, this is after lunch, so we had like 3 hours before, because our lunch is one, and then we had like 3 hours to do this afterwards. So we were just like hanging around waiting, not knowing what to do, and then they all got there, and then each one of them was just like, "No, it's like, there's no way we are letting you go down there." And then we got people from the town hall to come and look, and they were like, "Oh yeah, that's from the steps upstairs."
Oh.
And we're like, "What?" It's like, "Yeah, the stairs, like, on the town hall." And we were like, "Well, what is it? And like, is it like clean water? Is it just rainwater?" And they were like, "Ah, we don't know." They were like, "Oh, it could have mixed with sewage water. We don't really know."
Oh, shit.
So we're like, "Right." everyone get as far back as you can. We can't be anywhere near this water. So we got like right back. But the worst part is, in the morning, we'd set up all the props and stuff. So that was all down there. We didn't like, and it had like, we had some really nice props. Everything was down there. Luckily, we'd hired some nice costumes, and that was like a lot of money out of our budget. But they'd left them upstairs, so they weren't damaged. But we had to get some wellies. Like, we had to go to the pound shop and get some wellies, and then go like scuba diving in this little flood. And we had to get all these props out. And that took the rest of the day, and then we were like, what do we do? And then one of our teachers was like, oh, well, there's nothing we can do. It's like, you're going to have to be disqualified. And I was looking at him, and I was like, bruh, right. I was like, this is a natural occurrence. I was like, it's not like we flooded the cells. It's like, this was not nearly our fault. I was like, yeah. Disqualifying us and giving us a zero is not an option. I was like, we are making a film. And he was like, well, your only other option is to relocate. And I was like, right, that's what we'll do. And then he was like, well, you could relocate to here. And we had like a few rooms leading up to the cells. So he was like, you can have these rooms. And we were like, we're going to have to. And he's like, well, you're going to have to come up with a whole new storyboard and a whole new shot list and all this. And then you're going to have to do all that before tomorrow. And we were like, yeah, we can do that. And he was like, right, well, good luck. And then left. Because he had to go and check on all the other groups, obviously. So I kind of turned around, and then my director was like, what have you done? And I'm like, what do you mean, what have I done? And he's like, you just promised a brand new film for tomorrow. And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, we don't have that much time. And I'm like, did you want to get disqualified? Like, I'd rather try and make a film. Yeah, if we try and get 10 marks, it'd be better than not getting anything. I mean, so he was like, right, fine, but you're gonna help me come up with the shot list. And I'm like, well, it's my job anyway, so I might as well. And so yeah, we came up with this brand new shot list in record time. Like, no doubt, we did it in about an hour. And then we left, and then we came back the next day, and it was less flooded. It drained a bit, but it was still not in any condition to film in. So we stuck with our new plan, and we had three acts to film, but we were given an extra 2 hours. We were given until 6, we usually have until 5. We were given until 6 and we could start at 8. So we did. We got there at 8 and then started filming. And by lunchtime, we had just finished one act.
Yeah.
So we didn't have much time. Lunch was 1 again. We all got back about 2:15. And then we had until 6. Until 5:40, because we had to clean up, which takes about 20 minutes. Everyone was stressing out. We didn't know what to do. So we powered through and we did the essential film, like the essential bits to the film. And we're like, well, at least we can get some kind of film out of this. And in the end, we finished at about 5:10 after getting the essential things done, and then we went back and filmed some extra stuff, and we did some follies and some Atmos and all this stuff, and then I'm pretty proud of how we handled it, to be honest, considering not 24 hours before we got fucked over. We should have been getting a zero because of something completely out of our control. But instead, me and the director was just like, bitch, nah, not on our film. Yeah. We did all this, and we managed to do it, even with...
Can you use camera? Yeah, I got set up a tripod.
I won't name names, but even with a very annoying camera operator who didn't know how to set up a tripod, didn't know how to do a light balance, so most of our shots were over or underexposed until... me and the director came over, saw it on the monitor, and was like, yeah, no, we have to do that again.
Please tell me she knew how to zoom in.
And then didn't know how to do a proper pan. Didn't know how to...
Yeah.
That might be it. It was a she. It was a she. Which doesn't help the stereotypes.
Yep.
She knew how to zoom, but she didn't know how to focus. So, I mean, if you want to zoom, you're going to have to focus, aren't you? Especially if it's on manual, which it is. As filmmakers, we know everything should be on manual. Yeah. But then, yeah, so it's going to be edited. It's going into post on Friday. And then...
Nice. I'll give props for that story, man. No. That was a good story, man.
It's
going. It was interesting. Send for it. I can't wait to see them. Well, I can't really see
them. I know. I still need to know the link, but we'll get sent the link on Friday, I assume. So I'll just keep it.
Yeah. So
and
as soon
I'll
as I send it straight to me. If you
I should be able to. I might need to give you a password.
I can't wait to actually see your films. If you can put them on YouTube after that,
I don't
that,
know if
fine.
We can, because I think the school has rights to them. But we're allowed to use them in show reels. I just don't think we can put the full thing on YouTube.
Yeah. Well, I'm starting uploading. I think you're going to start uploading.
I definitely want to start doing vlogs and stuff. That's why I got this mic.
Yeah, I want to start doing some other things, because it gets a bit boring. You sit here and you're like, I need to do YouTube, but I've got an essay to plan for. You're like, but I want to make a video. And you go, yeah, but a video takes like an hour. You're like, no, it doesn't. Takes longer. But yeah, that's the end of our podcast for this one. We made it an hour long. We were planning to, but we just started just going off on tangents and stories, but it was pretty interesting.
It was.
If you liked it, we'll do one of these, I don't know, maybe every two
something
weeks
like
or
that,
whenever we've got stuff to talk about,
that's a good
basically
idea.
I'm not gonna make a plan of when we're going to do it, because I did that one for the last one and couldn't be bothered. We couldn't think of anything to talk about.
Whenever something comes up
me and Jack decide
to talk about.
Whenever we're both doing something, or whenever a new film comes out, or whenever we wanted to talk about some random stuff in film, we'll make a new podcast. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe to Jack Upload's channel.
Please do.
Because I'll leave a link in the description for it.
I'll leave a link to Jordan's online.
Good channel. Yeah. Well, no, it's going on to yours, isn't it, as well?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you just subscribe to us both. I don't know if the podcasts that we do are going to go up on both channels or going to alternate. We've not decided yet. But, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like. Check out my Twitter, at JordanBanks1997. Have you got Twitter, Jack?
Check out mine, Original Hobson.
Yep, don't forget to check out all the links in the description of my friends that helped in my film. If you want to put anything in your description, check out them as well. And see ya.
Bye.